I want to talk about the advice trap. I came across this Harvard Business School study recently that I think is really interesting and relates to the idea of advice and why taking more and more advice, in particular from successful people, might actually lead you astray, which is a little bit contrarian or contrary to what you would think. So this study was done by a professor named Michael Lavari, I believe it's pronounced, and basically what he did was he got thousands of participants to play a word scramble game, so a bunch of letters, and try to find as many words as you can in a certain allotted period of time. And then what they did was, after the first round of performance by participants, they pulled out a bunch of participants and had them give advice to people who were going to continue playing the game about how to do it and how to be successful at the game. Naturally, you would assume that people that were good at playing the word scramble game would give good advice. It seems obvious that that would be the case. They would identify why they were good at the game and then provide advice to the future players that would help them be better. Well, what did they actually find? The opposite, frankly. People that were good at playing the game were no better at giving advice than people who were bad at playing the game. What they did do was they gave more advice. So people who were good at the game, I'll say it again, people who were good at the game did not give better advice, but they gave more advice. And the people that were playing the game and receiving the advice assumed that the quantity of advice given related to the quality of the advice given. So they would hear from someone who was giving them tons of advice, and they would assume as a result that it was going to be better advice. That same thing happens in the real world. People who are successful, quote unquote, tend to give a whole lot of advice. They talk about what their strategy was, they talk about how they approach things, what their game plan was, but we need to be wary of taking all of it, because it may not be that they are actually better, that they're actually giving better advice than the average person. Now, I was trying to deconstruct that and understand a little bit more about how that could be the case, because you would think that when someone is successful at something, that they could pass on their wisdom to other people that are in the future going to do it. But what I would hypothesize is that a lot of times people are successful and they actually don't know why, at the core of it, they succeeded at the thing. They're actually quite bad at identifying what it actually was. What was the atomic unit, if you will, of their success? And so as a result, they're not able to give good advice to future people because they can't actually identify what it was that made them successful. They can throw a bunch of ideas out on a piece of paper. They can talk a lot about their strategy, but the reality is that what they're doing is applying a strategy ex post to something that was actually just action-oriented. They were just testing and learning, and now they're gonna go ahead and talk about it as though there were a concrete strategy in the past. So what can you learn from all this? You know, for me, what it means is that we need to spend less time gathering advice and more time acting. I think it can be useful to a certain extent at the very early days to gather a little bit of advice that gives you some of the initial sort of potential energy that you can then act upon, that you can convert into kinetic energy to get started. After that, you just need to take action. You just need to move and then test and learn as you go. The challenge is, when you gather too much advice, what you're doing is you're taking a whole bunch of other people's maps and then trying to apply it to your terrain. And your terrain is going to be fundamentally different because you have an entirely different set of circumstances and situations than anyone else who has encountered this, even if they're in the exact same arena. For example, a lot of people come and ask me about how to start creating a newsletter. For those of you who don't know, I write a newsletter that now reaches, 750,000 people. I send it out twice a week. It's grown, over the last 3 years. And so a lot of people seek me out for advice on growing their newsletter. Well, when I started writing and growing my newsletter, it was a totally different environment than it is today. There were fewer newsletters out there. Newsletters weren't a big business in the way they are today, where people are attacking them and approaching them with a lot of excitement at the outset. So it was a different environment. So I can give you advice on certain what I would view as like first principles of creating your newsletter, but I cannot give you advice on the entirety of the terrain that you are going to encounter as you go to grow yours. And it would be a fool's errand for you to try to follow all the advice I give, because I can give you a lot of it, but chances are a lot of it's going to be wrong in the context of the current environment. So, point of all of this, be wary of taking more and more advice from people. Take a little bit of advice to get you started, but then focus on action. Stop gathering more information and start acting on the information that you already have. That's your rule for life. That's the lesson for today. Something that I've been thinking about a lot and something that I'm going to try to act upon more and more is to just stop gathering more and more advice. Stop clouding my field of vision with more and more advice and start focusing on acting on what I already know. That's all for today. As always, until next time, let's get cold.